Goody, thank you for sitting down with us to sort of recap the season and look ahead to 2020. We know that it was a pretty disappointing year. What areas have you and the coaching group identified that were really at fault for this year?
There was plenty that was at fault. Clearly, it's pretty well documented our pre-season certainly wasn't anywhere near the level that we wanted to get for a variety of different reasons. And ultimately, at the end of that, we had a group that wasn't prepared for what the game was going to demand. So that was probably the starting point. And as the year unfolded, you know, our game style and our cohesion and efficiency in the way that we wanted to play just wasn't there. So now that leaves us with a bit to fix. But as a leader, I'm really comfortable with where that sits and how we're going to go about doing that.
I suppose what's been done behind the scenes to really address those issues going forward?
Well, clearly we've looked at every part of our department. You know, it's probably given us an opportunity to really reset, look at every area of our footy club and see where we can get the biggest improvements. You know, there will obviously be some changes within our staff. There'll be changes within our playing list, and obviously you've seen already the appointment of Alan Richardson coming into our coaching team, Darren Burgess into our high performance team. You can see that the club aren't going to sit still, and so that's just going to fix itself by having a good summer. There's other things in our program that we need to get right, and we're looking at every area of our club to do that.
And what impact do you think particularly Alan Richardson and Darren Burgess will have?
Yeah, obviously Alan comes from he's a really senior football figure. You know, he's done a lot of roles in coaching. He started in development and has worked his way through a variety of different roles and into a senior coaching position. So he brings a wealth of experience. He brings great perspective to a coaching program. So he's going to really work closely with the coaches about developing them, working with us to really make sure our processes are really aligned and committed to the vision that we're trying to create. So he's going to be a great asset to the club. And Darren Burgess is obviously world class. You know, he's done a lot in the high performance industry. He's been overseas. He's obviously coming from Arsenal. So he's someone that understands football, but he understands what high performance looks like. So they're two areas that we're really focused in on.
There were some big lessons learnt this year. How do you think those lessons will really shape the group going forward?
Oh, there's some enormous lessons to come out of this year, but it's really now about what we do and the actions that we do. We've got to own what happened in 2019. And we need to forge ahead. We need to be fitter. We need to be stronger. We need to be smarter in the way we play. We need to build a game style that our supporters go to the footy, they see it and they can associate with and they know what they're going to get from week to week. And it needs to be built to win finals. And that sounds like a big piece of work to undertake throughout the summer, but it's one that, you know, as a coach and a leader, I'm really confident in and something that I know our staff are, and we're going to go flat out to try and achieve it.
Given where we did finish this year, is there a hunger amongst the group from the coaches to the players to the staff overall?
Oh, there's enormous hunger. From where we got to where we finished this year, with that comes embarrassment, there comes some shame, there comes a feel of letting our supporters down. They're craving success. So there's an enormous hunger in the playing group. From when they left a few weeks ago, I'm seeing them already in the way they're going about their off-season, their training. They want to come back fit, ready to go to prove to themselves, but to prove to everyone else that they are a good footy team and they want to have success. So I've got no question there's an enormous hunger throughout the whole football club.
Just looking back on this season, there was a lot of expectation. How do you think that sort of affected the playing group overall?
Yeah, expectation is something that's in our industry no matter where you go. It's a stressful environment. The difference with us this year was that the expectation was probably at its peak. Now, we've probably been a club that hasn't had a lot of success over a long period of time. And when you get to a prelim final, there's an assumption that you're just going to go again and you're going to get to that grand final and you're going to win a first premiership since 1964. With that ramps up expectation. And that was really difficult to deal with because in some ways I think it might have taken our eye off the ball of what's really important. And it's about building the foundations that's going to create a really successful year. So, that we struggled with that, no question, right across the whole football club, from our players to our coaches to everyone. And that's something that will obviously be a great lesson in time of how we deal with that moving forward.
Do you think, I suppose, the group is closer because of that pressure that they did sort of face this year?
There's no question that when you go through adversity, it brings a group closer together and it realigns what's really important to you. One as an individual, but two as a collective. And there's no question that we're going to need each other to forge ahead again. And that togetherness piece is something that's going to be really strong on our agenda throughout the summer. But you know, the only way you get through adversity is to actually do something about it. And as I said, it's not going to come down to what we say we're going to do now. It's going to come down to our actual actions and how we go about building that again. And as I said, I'm really confident in our playing group, and I'm really confident in our staff and our club that we'll respond in the right manner.
It has been a pretty difficult year. How have you coped personally?
Yeah, look, I think, you know, I'm no different. I'm human like everyone out there. You feel pressure and you feel the embarrassment of the situation. And, you know, I was no different to a lot of our players. And, you know, I'm a people's person. You know, I love going out with my mates and sharing some good times. You know, I love spending time with my kids. I love going to my kids' sport. All those things in my life away from football became more challenging because of the situation, because of the embarrassment of where we sat as a footy club. And as a person, that's where I need to get better, that I need to be able to detach myself from my football and my job and my day-to-day living. And that's certainly from a personal development perspective, that's certainly something I'm going to be looking at in my off-season, about how I can cope with that situation better as a coach, because that's it's a big part of the longevity of coaching in this industry.
You are only a young coach, so how do you feel that those challenges will shape you going forward as both a coach and a person?
Yeah, look, I think, you know, every year you experience something different as a coach. You know, and this year was no different. You know, from going from a prelim to where we finished is something that probably not many coaches go through, but a lot have experienced in their time. And you almost have to go through it to get your pathway forward. And I know that I need to change the way that I go about some of my things in my life to make sure I can really flourish in the job that I've got. And I'm really cleared now a pathway forward personally for how I'm going to attack my coaching from here on in, but also I'm really clear on the pathway forward as a club. We've had some unbelievable reminders this year of what it takes to be successful, both as a collective and individually, how you use that adversity to grow.
Looking at the supporters, they've, I suppose, ridden every bump with you and with the club this year. What's your message to them heading into 2020?
My message to our supporters is really clear. This club's not the same club that it used to be. We've come a long way. And we've built this club on some great foundations. And it might seem right now that we're a long way away from where we want to get to. We're not. We're going to be a club that really responds in the right manner. And to our supporters, all I can say to you is keep the faith. I want to see you coming to the MCG in round one, knowing that you're going to see a team that's highly competitive, you see a brand that you can identify with, and you walk away from the MCG knowing that Melbourne Footy Club's going to have a good year.
The players are on break at the moment. When they do roll back into the club for day one of pre-season, what are you really expecting to see?
Oh, I think the way they come back to pre-season will show us, you know, their real commitment to making amends for this year. You know, there's no question that they look back and they know that the pre-season was one that they didn't get out of what they needed to, and they know the importance of not wasting time. And if they've learnt that lesson, they'll show us that they're ready to go on day one of pre-season, and I think it's going to be a really big indicator for us.
Coming off a season where we did finish 17th on the ladder, there is expected to be a lot of talk externally. How do you think the group will cope with that?
Yeah, look, you know, it's going to come down to our actions. You know, we'll be ultimately defined by what we do in 2020. And we can right the wrongs of 2019 with how we go about our business. Now, as I said, it's not going to be about what we say we're going to do. And, you know, we've got a whole summer to build that in. But ultimately, it's going to come down to how we play in 2020. And some people might say that might be just win-loss. For me, it's not just win-loss. It's actually being a really competitive team all the time and building this club back up to playing some finals footy.